Hey yo, what is going on gamers? It is I, ya boy. It has been a hell of a long time since I last did this, but it's finally the moment you have all been waiting for. Veteran Tips and Tricks, Episode 3, Sunbreak Edition. I decided this time I would take a little bit of advice from other people on the internet, you know, because you know, it's good to get a second input on a lot of these things, because, you know, despite me being probably the best Monster Hunter player, you know, it's sometimes good to get a second input. So, what I've done is I've gone on the web search, right, to see, look for some inspiration for a new build, and I found one here today on a nice little website called Jinx Esports TV. Now, what we've found here is, this is an article showing us the top 5 best longswords in Monster Hunter Rise Sunbreak. And now this is an esports website, so it has to be pretty accurate. Now we see the top longsword on the top 5 best longswords list is this one, the Titan Feller, which is the one we're using today. And it says, don't let its size fool you. The Titan Feller is a longsword that happens to be as massive as a great sword, which means it must do a lot of damage, right? It must do so much damage. Sporting one of the highest raw damage stats in the game. And while it is the sharpest weapon, guys, it is the sharpest weapon, which means it must be very good. The sharpest weapon. It has a wide variety of slots available, but that gives you some good customization options. And it only costs 60,000 zenny, which is not a lot of zenny, to be totally honest. So we're going to be running with this one today. We're going to be running with this weapon. It's pretty good. We got 380 attack, 747 defense, which is a little bit lower than it should be. I don't know why, but sometimes the game just gets a little bit buggy and it shows us the incorrect values. It should be a little bit higher than that. I don't know why it'd be lower. Anyways, what we've got here is defense boost level 7 and defiance level 5, which is going to give us a lot of defense, right? So much defense. That is the key of behind this build, right? Defense, staying alive. What we've got here is coalescence level 3. Now, what coalescence is going to do for us is that when we recover from a status or a blight, we get an attack buff of 18. We don't have any status or elemental attack power, so it doesn't matter. We're going to get 18 attack buff when we recover from blight. And we're going to be getting blighted pretty often because there's fire blight everywhere. I'll show you the quest we're doing in a minute. And we've got protective polish because they told us in the article that it was the sharpest weapon. It boasts one of the sharpest weapon stats. So we've got 90 seconds of protective polish to maintain the sharpness as much as possible. We also got quick sheath for long sword. We got blight resistance is going to help us out, help us recover from some blights, right? Poison resistance level 3 is going to help us not get poisoned. You know, I don't know, it's not a big deal, that one. And we've also got foray. Now, what foray does, it's a powerhouse of a skill. One of my friends actually recommended this to me. He says the best skill in the game. What it does is it increases attack power and affinity by 20% when it activates. And when it activates is when you get poisoned by the monster. So, you know, it's going to increase our damage so much, you know, make our already powerful weapon one of the quickest weapons, the most powerful weapons of the game. Our runs are going to go so fast, like quick, like Thanos snap, you know, super quick. Handicraft level 2 to even bring our sharpness even further beyond. Going to make it one of the sharpest weapons. And we also have a fortify, which we're not really going to be needing to use, but that's okay. We got it with us anyway. And Mail of Hellfire, don't really know what that one does. And Spirit Bird's Call, which is going to give us Spirit Birds throughout the quest, which is super handy. Super handy skill to have. I also think this looks like one of the best sets in the game. It's super beautiful. Bruh. Looks really good. Anyways, I'm going to go sit down and eat some food now. Eat some of my dangos. Anyways, guys, let's get down to business. The quest that we're going to be doing today is going to be this one of these Master Rank event quests. Now, Capcom's been rolling out their events. Most of them are pretty easy. Most of them are pretty easy, but this one's going to be, you know, it's probably still a pretty easy quest, but we're going to do this one. Anyways, we're going to go down now. And would you just look at that sharpness on my weapon? It's so high. Look at it. It's such a long bar. I'm going to sharpen to proc my protective polish. It's going to help us out a lot. Better get this to increase our attack as well. Wow, I didn't think that roar was going to hit me. It was actually a little bit far away. Now, would you look at this? I take... Okay, that was a little bit more damage than I was expecting, but that's okay. What's my defense at? 760. Yeah, it should be pretty high. Oh yeah, would you look at that damage? We whiffed a couple of attacks there, but you know, whiffing isn't actually too bad for us. Not actually too bad. We still get pretty optimal run times, even when we whiff. It's all about survivability, guys. It's all about staying alive. So you can keep hitting the monster. Don't know why my attacks keep bouncing. I actually am meant to supposed to, you know, have one of the toughest weapons, right? But my attacks kind of keep, like, bouncing off the monster. Don't know how I didn't counter it there. Kind of seemed like I was supposed to counter it, but... well, whatever. It's not a big deal. I don't know why its head gets all red like this. See, look at that. We didn't even get fire blighted. I'm gonna use a potion just in case. I wouldn't normally recommend using potions. It's better actually to just go for more damage per second. DPS, that's what it's called. Damage per second. What? The heck? I meant to have fire resistance. I mean, okay, well, guys, that card was on purpose anyways. Because I was going to show you, now we have more defense with the Fortify, see? Look at our defense. Look how high our defense is now. It's 877. We have so much defense. I mean, I was just proccing Fortify there on purpose, pretty much. But I mean, still, that damage seemed a little bit high for when we have 18 fire resistance. Seems pretty stupid to me. But that's okay, we're gonna get back into, you know... quickly killing this gold Rathian so we can get on to the real business, you know. The silver Rathalos. Should be a pretty easy monster as well. But we're supposed to have poison resistance level 3. It's okay though, because this is a what? Huh? I meant to have poison resistance level 3. It's meant to stop the poison. The heck? Well, at least this is proccing my 4A.
Bruh.
I'm gonna go back in. I'm gonna play super safe from now on. Gonna play super safe. Gonna keep things extra tidy. Not gonna get hit for the rest of the quest, probably. When I get serious, that's one thing you gotta know about me. When I get serious, you really don't wanna see me when I'm serious. I get really good, and I get kinda... you know, I don't like to get serious on quests because I don't talk as much, you know. I have to concentrate. This must be a bug, because the poison keeps proccing even though I have poison resistance level 3. That seems a little bit stupid to me. I think Capcom has just overlooked a couple of things, if I'm being totally honest. Capcom just kind of got their stuff wrong. It's okay, it happens, you know. They're a relatively new company to the scene, you know, relatively new game developer. It's fine. I forgive them for it, but I really wish that'd make their games a little bit less janky, you know, for times like this. Because my set is virtually flawless, right? It's literally probably the best set you can actually make in the game. And my sword is bouncing off when the esports website actually told me that it was the sharpest weapon in the game. Now, who would you believe? Would you believe Capcom, a really new development team, or would you believe the esports website? I know who I'm believing, but you guys can pick for yourselves. See, that shouldn't be bouncing off. That should be dealing more damage. Especially when this is one of the highest raw attack weapons in the game. Also from the gaming esports website, you know. An actual reputable source of information. I'm a little confused as well as to why my spirit birds haven't been coming during the quest, though. Maybe another bug. Ah, well. I've played the game for long enough now that I'm used to the bad hitboxes and the stupid bugs and stuff. Let me just sharpen my weapon here. Get it back up to the end of its big long bar. That attack didn't even matter. You see how much defense I've got? I've got over 1,000 defense. I'm never gonna die again. With this mixed set, it's so good.
Are you sure about that?
You really expect me to die to such pathetic attacks? I am Bracky, Lord of Optimal Gamers. You can't defeat me. That did quite a lot of damage, actually. I should have countered that. Actually, that was a perfect timing on the counter. Oh, here's the Silver Rathalos. He came a little bit quicker than I expected. I should not be poisoned. Seems a little ridiculous to me that I'm still poisoned. But you know, it is what it is. Boy, if I had a penny for every time I said it is what it is on this video, but that's kind of on Capcom. They should actually be paying me for finding all these bugs in their video game. Capcom should actually be paying me for this. Should have picked up some more mega potions while I was in base camp last time. You know, I did a tactical cart to get back to base camp so that I could proc fortify. That's on me though. That's on me. That's a player error. And you know, the thing to remember here is that I do make mistakes, you know. Even if I am probably the best player, I actually do make a couple of mistakes. It's okay though, because the gold Rathian is actually almost been killed. It's actually almost dead. Pretty easy. Quick smart 10-minute hunt for the gold Rathian. Not a big deal. Like I said before, you know, Rathian's probably one. What? Whatever. I don't know why I'm having to drink an antidote mid-quest. I'm gonna go back to base. This is some bullshit, actually. Okay, I'm not gonna... I gotta watch my language on the YouTube sometimes. I actually got a warning on the last one because I swore a couple too many times. At least now that I have my fortify all procced up, you know, I'm dealing a massive damage and I don't actually take that much damage from the monsters. Which is actually kind of the main thing. And look, now we can ride the Golden Rathian. Not that I want to ride such a stupid monster anyways, but I'm just going to run the Rathian into the wall. Excuse me? I ran it into the wall where the thing was, and it didn't work. Well, it's dead now anyways. I don't have to look at it anymore. Let's fight this Silver Rathalos. I actually do need a Rathian plate, though. A mantle, I mean. That is kind of why I use that food skill in the first place. I don't know why am I not getting the fire blight? Why am I not getting fire blighted? Because I'm that's meant to proc the coalescence, but it's not doing it. Coalescence is meant to be our main skill here, and the fortify as well. I mean, not the fortify, the foray. I mean, the fortify is doing work, but I mean, I wouldn't normally recommend using it, but. Wow, we're kind of past that point now where we are using it. It's pretty good. Like I said, like if you want to get the big numbers, you know, it's the number one way to do it. The sheer amount of damage you can get is completely absurd, but resuscitate in coalescence cannot proc at the moment, and I don't know why. I proc'd once earlier. Now, I don't know how many of you guys know this, but there's actually a hidden technique in the Monster Hunter series, and what you do is you can actually put a bomb down, because the bomb does a lot of damage. And I'll go like this. Boom. See that? 480. I actually got double the damage on that one bomb. Why is my weapon bouncing still? It's so stupid. This is meant to be the sharpest weapon. The Jinx TV told me that it was the sharpest weapon and it's still bouncing. I don't really understand why. This isn't going to win any speedrun competitions, you know, this run here. But, I mean, it's just because the game's been playing up, you know. I guarantee you guys, this actually is the best build you can get in the game. You know, I'm a bit of a... What?! God, I was really hoping things would have changed at least a little bit in the past year. You know, they could have fixed some of these bugs. But I had less defense than I was meant to have for no reason. I wasn't getting any spirit birds throughout the quest for no reason. You know, I wasn't getting fire blight for no reason. And then I got poisoned even when I had poison resistance for no reason. It's bullshit, man. You know, I think after this, I don't know, maybe you can say what you want. Maybe I need to train some more with the longsword. I was doing pretty well, I thought. You know, 1736, that's a pretty good time, right? That's a pretty good time. You know, it's going to hold up against some of the best speedrunners. You know, I think it would actually put that I think it would give that Peppo man a run for his money. I don't know. I think I'm actually pretty good. But yeah, this has just been kind of... Got a doo-doo, man. I didn't want to have to say it, but I think I'm going to have to say it. Let's not derive Sunbreak. I think this game is trash. This game's kind of trash. I don't know if I'll be recording more of this. 100 likes and I record another. Whatever. Game's doo-doo. I'll see you in the next one.